Hey, morning everyone. What's up? What's up? What's up? God is good all the time. All the time, God is good. I hope you didn't forget to say thank you, Jesus, for waking me up. If you did, say thank you, Lord, for waking me up. Thank you for waking me up in my right mind. Thank you for allowing me to see this beautiful, this bright day which you have made. Help me to rejoice and to be glad in it. I just want to encourage somebody today that God's tremendous, God's gracious, God's bold blessings are a sure shot on your life. Just dare to believe God and to pray bold prayers. Don't pray menial prayers. Don't just say, boy, I need a job just to pay my bills. No, say, I need a job to not only to pay my bills and to take care of myself, but most importantly, to help others, to build others, to maybe help somebody else to pay their bills. You know, Lord, I want to. Most times we work hard so that we can get our own home, our homes. You know, let us pray bold prayers that we'd not only be able to buy our own homes, but to maybe help somebody get a home, you know, get a car and all of that. That the scripture says that we are the lenders, not borrowers. That's what you want to be. You want to be in abundance. Pray that God give you abundance, not just any mediocre or any little menial prayer, but pray big prayers. The scripture says we have not because we ask not. It says we have not because we pray amiss. And I think the original meaning of amiss is that we pray very weak prayers. The prayers are very weak. It's not built on faith. And I know sometimes our feelings may be very low at the moment. You know, I'm not talking about your feelings because feelings come and go. Because sometimes I may be talking to you in a positive manner, but maybe within I may feel a little bit low. You know, there are days like that. But it's about where your mind is and your belief on God. Do you believe that God can answer your bold prayers, whatever is deep seated and deep rooted in your heart? Do you believe that whatever it is that you desire, God can answer it? You see, it says when you delight yourself in God, He will answer. He will grant your very need, and He will give you the desires of your heart. All right. So yes, morning to you, Natoya Henry Brown. I'm glad that you gave God thanks for such a beautiful morning. God is great. God isn't just only, I mean, great is not even the right adjective to describe who He is. Great is a weak word. He is just beyond what we can ever even think or imagine. God is just excellent. Now I'm encouraging you. There is absolutely nothing that is impossible with God. I mean, this is just, it goes without saying. Absolutely, there is nothing impossible without God. Sometimes you're afraid to even express what it is you desire to become or whatever it is you desire to do because you're afraid that persons may shut it down or shoot it down or say you can't accomplish it or you can't accomplish this. Trust me, nobody listen to the critics. Whatever God says, that is what will be. That is what will happen. It can come to pass. Whatever it is that you desire to become, whatever it is that you desire to do, it is possible. I'm speaking that into your life because I know that God can do the impossible. He specializes in the impossible. It don't matter if it is that you're ill. It don't matter if it is that you're broke. It doesn't matter whatever your state may be. If you're depressed, God is able to deliver you. God is able to see you through. And just pray bold prayer. Don't just pray that, oh God, deliver me from this specific thing. Just say, Lord, help me to be delivered so that I can help others out of their own situation or situations. So pray big prayers. Believe God that He can deliver you. Believe that God can provide for you, not only just to satisfy the bare minimum, but that you're in abundance, that your storehouse can't even contain. That is how great God is. That is how big God is. Don't even watch it in a natural, because if you only use your natural eyes to watch it, it's going to seem impossible. I can tell you that, because sometimes I mean, I have very big prayers and bold dreams, and when I look at it, I say, boy, God, if left up to me, but really the chaos, say how it will happen. But you know, that part is not for us to figure out. That is God's duty to figure out that. Just say, God, I declare and I believe that I'm highly favored, that I'm blessed, that I'm confident, that I'm beautiful, that I'm handsome, as the case may be, that I'm gifted, that I have the ability to do my job. I have the ability to become greater than what I am presently, that I will be, you know, I mean, the child of the Most High God, that, I mean, I will live the life that I must go down in history as a history maker in some things or things that are great, things that are positive. You follow what I'm saying? I believe that I can be the next, what's his name, Martin Luther King, all of these great people. It is possible. There is nothing that is impossible with God. You just have to believe. You just have to trust. Keep that hope burning. If you find that there are times it kind of falter, because that's how we are as human beings, you know, we are frail, you know, we will make mistakes at times. Just, you know, sometimes you have to say, just kind of speak against your feelings and say, no, I am blessed. I'm highly favored. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. I can achieve my dream. I will achieve my dream. I shall achieve my dream. It is not impossible. It is possible. You just have to dare. You just have to believe. You have to trust God. You can do it. You can achieve it. I can tell you that it is possible. It doesn't matter who may say to you it is impossible, because our minds are finite, but God's mind is infinite. Our ways, our thoughts, our actions are not like God's ways, thoughts, our actions. You can dare to dream big dreams. You can dare to achieve. It is not impossible. I am not one to believe in things that are impossible. There's absolutely nothing that is impossible. Anything that you want to become, anything that you want to achieve, it can be done. Don't just pray mediocre prayers. You want to be a big business mogul? It can happen. It can happen. Can you imagine if all of these big business moguls in Jamaica or across the world had said, "Chuck, we just want one little store, just wanted to, you know, maybe just reach a few little persons." No, when me talk, I want to be able to one day reach billions of people. You know what I mean? When I'm singing, I want to be able to reach billions of people. I don't just want to just say I want to reach thousands of people. I'm daring to dream big dreams. You know what I mean? Say, "Lord, I want to be as maybe wealthy as Bill Gates, Rockefeller, I don't even remember some of the names right now, Donald Trump, Oprah Winfrey, whoever it is that you may admire, whoever it is that you may emulate in some way, whatever, whoever it may be, whatever it is that you desire, whatever it is that you dream, it can happen. It is possible. It is not impossible. God is a God of impossibles. He specializes in it. You don't worry about it. Your mind is finite, so you can't even imagine it. You can't even think it. Sometimes you probably can't even ask it, because when you ask it, it just seems way out. It just seems very far-fetched. That's me. When I pray very far-fetched, way out, extraordinary prayers. Believe you me, sometimes if you hear it, you probably laugh. Yes, I really. She really think that she can accomplish it. Yes, I can. With God, I can. I can't do it in and of myself, but with God, I can. I believe God for that. He is able. He's able to accomplish it. There is nothing that he cannot do. He owns the entire earth. He owns the world. The world is wealthy. So why it is that I can't accomplish that? Whatever it is that I desire, it can be done. And I'm talking about good desires now. I'm talking about desire to do something wicked to somebody. I'm talking about desires that are good, things that are lovely, things that are just of a good report. You know what I'm saying? So whatever great thing that you want to accomplish, it can be done. Don't doubt yourself. Even if the doubters come, just in your mind, because sometimes you're going to be around people who are very doubtful or who will not believe in your own dream. So sadly, it can be families, it can be your closest friends. But in the back of your mind, when they come with it, just say, "You know what, God, in spite of what they're saying, I know it can be done. I know it can be achieved." You may not see today, you may not see tomorrow, you may not see next week, you may not even see it in 2017. But as long as you have life, as long as you have breath, and your faculties are all in place, it can happen for 2018. It can happen for 2019. Whenever it is that God says it will, you just have to trust God. It can happen. You can achieve it. There is absolutely nothing impossible with God. You just have to hold on. You just have to trust him. I'm talking to you as I'm talking to myself. It is not impossible. All right, God is able to see you through. God is able to carry you through. God is able to accomplish your dreams. You yourself know your own deep-seated dream. Pray it and say, "God, this is what I truly want to become." Don't limit it because you're afraid to say, "Oh," like sometimes I hear people say this, "Oh God, I never say something annoying me like this. I just want to be able to afford." Really? I just want to be able to afford. And that is really, sometimes for me, that is really praying amiss, really not trusting God. Why would you not want to more than it to be able to afford? Why would you not want to be able to do great things, not only for yourselves and for your families, but for other people? People, let me tell you, me want wealthy. Is there a thing called being a multi-billionaire? Whether or not there is a thing called that, that's what me want. I want to be wealthy. Why would I just want to can afford? You know what I'm saying? And I'm not saying that wealth is the only thing that we must strive for. Clearly not. Health is key because, boy, if you don't have your health, you have nothing. Salvation is above all of these things. But I'm talking about, I'm speaking about wealth because it really takes cash to care. You know, and a number of our problems across the world is finance. You know, people struggle and they can't do this, they can't do that because of finance. I'm just saying to you that whatever it is that you desire, pray it. If you got that, there's a reason why you get that desire. I'm talking about good desires now. You know, there's a reason why you may decide that you want to become an entertainer, like what I would want to become, a good singer out there, you know, reaching billions of people. You may want to become a doctor, you may want to become a lawyer, but you may say, boy, it's too old. If you research a lot of these artists and actresses and so on, many of them, or a lot of them, the big ones that we know, started very late in life. There was a lady who was very poor, and she just resigned to being poor. You know, and when she was in her 50s, I think she had an idea because she was a business lady within. She just had that ability, and she presented her business proposal to somebody, and that was it. She became a wealthy woman in her 50s. I'm saying it's never too late for a shower of rain. I wouldn't even say a shower, a pouring, outpouring of rain. You know what I mean? You just have to trust God. You have to just continue. I can't tell you when you're going to accomplish it, but you have to start to plant the seeds from now. Water it. Trust God. And just keep doing, even when the doubters come, even when you yourself become doubtful and say, oh God, it has been a year, it has been two, you know. But sometimes it's for us to develop patience, self-control. Those things are virtuous. Those things are important. You know what I'm saying? So sometimes when the prayers take long to answer, it just occurred to me right now that we have to develop a virtuous nature. You know, patience is key. And as human beings, sometimes we get impatient. I can tell it at me. Gosh, that is something that we have to develop. We have to hone that. We have to, you know, make that become a part of us. So sometimes when your prayers takes long to answer, is to develop that. That when things happen, when challenges arise, you will just arise. You will be able to trust God and say, you know what? I've been through something. God will deliver me. I don't know when, but it will happen. All right, people? So dare to dream big dreams. Remember, we're on positivity, no negativity. God is good. Your dreams can be accomplished. Your desires can come to pass. Just honor God. Just obey God. Just trust Him. Believe in Him. Have hope. Do not give up. Even when the doubters come, just know that God is able to do abundantly above that you can ever ask, think, or imagine. You hear what you can even ask. So sometimes you feel you ask something way out. So God can accomplish something greater than your way out desires, or what you've asked, or even thought of, or even imagine. And you know, sometimes our mind imagines some great things that we would love to accomplish. I'd love to go on in history, like how, in terms of making a big change, as how maybe Martin Luther King or other heroes had made. You know what I mean? I'd love to have long life, health, strength, and wealth. Of course, I want to be wealthy. You know what I'm saying? And not for wealth to just show off on anybody. Say, oh, I live in this lovely house. Oh, I drive these cars or something like that. Those are nice things, yes. But really to make some positive impact on somebody else's life. That's important. Service is key. You know what I mean? I fail to see how you can live this life without impacting on somebody else's life positively. Too much negativity. We're coming against that. We come against that in Jesus' name. It's time for positivity now. We just, every day we get up, Lord, we don't have no money for this. Lord, we don't have no money for that. Lord, we're broke. Lord, we're sick. Lord, we're this. Just always some kind of negativity. We're going to replace our bad habits with good habits. All right? There are sometimes during the course of the day when I just feel like the doubts coming on and the solemnness and the sadness coming on, it's like I just utter a word, no. I am blessed. I'm highly favored by God. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Sometimes you may not have that, the impetus and that drive and that oomph, you know, that zeal to pray out heavy every single day. Because there are down days, you know. There are days where you just, inside you just kind of feel that way. You just said, boy, Lord, I trust in you. Lord, I can accomplish this. Even if it's just those two lines, until you wake up your soul, until you wake up your heart, until you wake back up your mind to say, God, I know that you can do it. As I'm talking to you, I'm speaking this into being over your lives, over your family's life, over your friend's life. Speak a word of positivity over your children's life, over your mother, your father, your husband, your wife. Just speak it. Write down something positive. Whatever it is that you have to do, look at them and say, I like this about them. I love this about them. Just put aside the negativity for now. Just put that aside and just start to train your mind. Because what you want to do is replace bad habits with good habits. Because God is able. He's able. He is able. He is able. You can do it. You can achieve it. I believe in you, but most importantly, God believes in you, but you have to believe in yourself for that seed to grow and to flourish. Just think of how a tree is planted. Research it. Look at what has to happen. That is how you have to treat you. In spite of when the doubters come or the drought comes, believe that God can and God will above what you can ever ask, think, or imagine. It is possible. Just continue to trust God. Continue to have that belief. Hone it. Believe it. Just water it. Do not give up. It is possible. It is not impossible. I'm speaking to you as I'm speaking to my own heart. All right? My beautiful people, my wonderful people, have a beautiful day. Have a blessed day. You are highly favored by God. It doesn't matter what anyone wants to say, think, or believe about you. Just know who you are in God. Just know who you are as an individual. And know that you can accomplish every single dream that you have dreamed and desired. Even if no one believes in you. Alright? But God believes in you. Have a great day. Be blessed.